Rolling
Plains
Art with a capital A.
Galleries.
Rolling Plains Art Gallery is the signature outreach program for the Plains Art Museum. It is a 48-foot long semi-trailer which has been outfitted for a traveling gallery of fine art.
I was excited by the opportunity that the Plains has given us as regional artists to be presented to a larger audience.
What a wonderful experience to have a trailer like this to come around, a museum on wheels.
I like the idea of a traveling art exhibition that would reach out to people that normally wouldn't get to see art.
A week of fun, a week of learning about the whole artistic experience. The truck comes into town, it parks, and it's open to the public free of charge. We have an on-site staff person, our assistant curator of outreach, who is with the gallery. She provides tours, and school kids come through at various points throughout the week. It's also open to the community at night and on weekends. This year, for the two-year tour, we're doing an exhibition called Art of Today.
I think the Art of Today is getting more interesting. It's more individual than it used to be. There used to be more focused veins of styles of painting or ways of sculpting. And I think the creativity and the individuality of the work in the Red River Valley is real diverse and real exciting.
If it's visually interesting, if something happens that they haven't seen before, that's art. And in today's world, there's so many interesting things out there.
I feel that it's valid if a person is making the effort to express themselves or going through the process of creating something.
A lot of work that I see today, it seems like it's all very much up here, and it's you need to go up to the wall and read this big long description about the piece and to understand it. And I think that part of it, at least one level of it, should hit you here.
I drew endlessly, I guess, as a very young child, and I remember drawing a lot. And I had some small ability at it, not a great drawer, but I had some ability at it, and I guess I was encouraged throughout school, even though we didn't have art classes. There's always somebody, well, he's the class artist, or he can draw, so have him draw the poster, or have him draw something. There are no boundaries about what you can think about as visual art. The things that really inspire me the most are the rodeo and the action of the rodeo, and of things that are part of Western Americana. The rodeo pieces, I'm thinking more along the lines of a particular position of a horse and rider and how that would fit compositionally on the page. The rest of it is pretty much intuitive in terms of the color. I'll start out with various colors and they change many times during the painting process. Paint can be fluid, and that paint can drip, and that paint can run. And when it does drip and run and splatter, it usually is because it's put on there with some sort of energy. The piece that they selected for this tour, Toka Iape, those are words of the Dakota Nation, and they're words that came out of a language book by Paul Warcloud, who is a Sisseton Sioux from South Dakota. Toka can mean stranger or it can mean enemy. Iape is like a sign or talk. It deals with the language that's used between strangers. And so that's where the sign language comes from in here. It is Indian sign language that I've used. But I don't have a lot of preconceived notions about what the piece is going to look like in the end. And I find that's very good, because if you try to match too closely what's in your mind, it becomes pretty restrictive. It doesn't give you a chance to problem solve. Part of the challenge of it is solving the problems that you get yourself into as an artist, as a painter. And it can be kind of terrifying sometimes to have a painting fall apart, but also it can be very exhilarating when you solve the problem, and that's what makes it fun.
I always thought I was going to be an artist or a rock star. I just always enjoyed drawing. I did a lot of cartooning, and I used to make these little animated flip books. I've been working on the same series for about 2 or 3 years, where it's just been these buildings and local landscapes, and I just decided to do some playing in my studio. I wanted to try something different. I've done a lot of Dairy Queens in my drawings, so I thought it was a natural step to pick something I already kind of knew the shape of and had done a lot of, and I already had tons of photos and memories of the Dairy Queen. Every time you go through a small town, you say, okay, there's the Ben Franklin, there's the Dairy Queen. It's kind of the standard one that you see now most places. It's sort of it's not the newest one, but it seems like it's the most common one. And then I did one down the street from it in St. Paul on Larpenteur and Lexington Avenues, and it's got the old style. It's got the old sign, and it's got kind of a wackier sloped roof. Then I did the one in Fargo because it has a barn-shaped roof. From this step, I'll go to do the interiors. So I did the interior of the space. I had no illusions that they were going to come out looking like a professional model making job. I kind of wanted them to have a little bit of my character, which is a little bit, my work is kind of sloppy.
I was involved in clay when I was in high school. I was very much a vessel maker back then. The glass, when I first found it, really suited my personality. It's very hot and very focused, and it's one long process from beginning to end. There's no stop and wait, and so it's a beginning to end process, and I find that real exciting. It's also very frustrating, which I find fascinating. Glass is all made out of sand. I like the material. I like working with the material. That's where my joy of it comes from. It's not the objects or the finished image or the colors. It's the working the material. Physical forces are what I really enjoy. When I have hot glass on a pipe and I point it down and I can elongate it just by letting gravity take a hold of it and pull it, I find that really fascinating. I do this for a living. I'm a full-time maker in my backyard, and I'm able to make a living and pay my mortgage. I have two bodies of work that I do. I do the blown vessels. That's what I do for a living. That's my craft. And then I also do sculptural work, like what you see behind me, that's more conceptual-based. The piece that's in the show is a large blown glass vase with blue trails, and then large clear handles and a large clear foot. So it's a piece that two people had to make. Somebody else had to bring me all of the small bits that adorn the vessel. You keep working off the work you've been making. So I was working with the trails, and the colors to me I pick out before the process even starts, and they need to be laid out on the table and made ready. Some have to be heated up. So that's an intellectual process that happens before. When I'm working them, they're all orange. So it's mostly working off the work that you did the day before, the week before, and using those learning experiences to push a little farther, push a little more.
I guess when I was young I wanted to be an artist, but I also wanted to be a lot of other different things, like a musician and an astronaut and a math teacher. Once I got to high school, I really felt the need to start expressing who I was, and so art became the easiest and most natural way for me to show people who I was and what was going on inside me. Art can be anything you want it to be. The piece that's in the show is called Iron Out the Wrinkles. It has Iron Out the Wrinkles of Myself written all over it, and it's part of a series called the Daily Affirmation series that I did. Childlike artwork with an adult meaning to it. Basically, I'm using everyday objects as metaphors for things that we all struggle with in our daily lives. By using these everyday objects, it would be easy for people to identify with the message and also lighten it up so it wasn't so serious. So Iron Out the Wrinkles, I guess, would be about working through different stresses. It might be different for everybody. Maybe it's learning to stand up for yourself or how to work with other people, just learning how to iron out the different wrinkles in your life. There's a few different ways that I work. One thing that I do that I'm realizing how valuable it has been to me is to keep like a little sketch journal, and not anything complex, just little teeny sketches about what I'm feeling or something I'm thinking about. And then I'll just come back to those little drawings and I'll transform them into paintings or prints. Kids inspire me. I've been teaching for these last 2 years and I love being able to share my view of art with them. And that's been really rewarding for me because I still feel like I identify a lot with the child part of me.